Hi, I'm Lisa Marie. Welcome to my channel, Living My Best Life with Lisa Marie. Today's video is a mystery box challenge. Home with Rebecca Jane gathered a bunch of us friends together, and we all shopped our stash and sent each other boxes of items, and some of them are required that we absolutely have to use. And I'm super excited. So don't forget to visit the playlist down below and also Home with Rebecca Jane, because she did a great job putting this together. It's our second time doing a mystery box and it's a lot of work. So thanks, Rebecca.
I'm also gonna have a link below to the person who I sent my box to. So if you wanna see the fun things that I sent to them and what they did with them, don't forget to go to that link next.
So I've got my box and I'm gonna open it right now for you. It's my first time seeing it. I have not looked inside this box. And I'm very excited, so here we go. Here is my box, and I sliced open the top, but I have not looked inside. All right, okay, here we go. Floral foam, which I don't actually have this size or shape. Thank you, this is awesome. All right, ooh, I've got a wreath. Let's see, this is a wood blend wreath, and I love the size. This is gonna be great, okay. And let's see here, I've got a keychain, and it's a graduation 2021. That's cute. Alrighty. And ooh, a succulent in a little pot. Those are always gonna come in handy for sure. Let's see here. Oh, what a cute little sign. Oh my gosh, I have never seen this sign before. Super cute. I love this. Oh my gosh, can you see that? There we go, thank you. Next item is this little box. Okay, this is cute. Look at the little, how adorable is that? But I love the shape. It looks like a flower. I don't know if I've ever seen one like that. Gosh. Ooh, watermelon plates. Yep, that will definitely come in handy next spring, summer. I love these. I really do. This is awesome. Okay. Ooh, Mardi Gras beads. Well, I don't think they're Mardi Gras color, but they are... Whoops, they are red beads, which, you know, you can paint these and turn them into so many things. So I love this. You never have too many of those. Alrighty. Okay, let's see. I've got a mesh laundry bag. This is great. I mean, honestly, there's so much you can do with this too. How awesome is that? That's great. Okay, and then let's see. Oh, how cool is that? Buffalo check wall borders. Oh, no question. That is gonna come in handy. Love it. I have never seen these. Are these from Dollar Tree? Maybe, I don't know. Well, I've never seen them. Okay, let's see, we've got straws. Oh, how cute are these with the little leaves on them? Let's party straws, how adorable. I love these. I've used straws to make different things before. Okay, and it looks like everything else is wrapped. Let me see, make sure. Yep, okay, it looks like everything else is wrapped, and then there's a lot of like stuffing stuff in here. Okay, now I do know who this is from, even though I don't see a card or anything in it, but this box, I could tell by the address, was from Crafty Leany. So thank you, Leany. Let's open up the wrapped ones. These are the ones that I have to use no matter what. Okay, let's see here. So here's the first one, is wrapped up. Oh, how adorable. Unbelievably blessed. This is so cute. Look at this little teeny mug. Oh my gosh. This is adorable. Oh, I love this. Now I gotta come up with something I'm gonna do with that, because that is super cute. All right, the next required item is, let's see here. Feels like a terracotta pot. Let's see if I'm right. Oh, it is. Ooh, nice. How cute is that? A little terracotta pot. I love these. Okay. And then I believe there's one more required item. So I thought I had to have three required items. So maybe one fell out of wrapping. I will have to get in touch with Leany and find out if there was a third one and which one that is that I'll be required to use. But in the meantime, this is a great start. And now I got to get to thinking about what I'm going to make. And that comes next. So come along with me.
If I mention that I bought something at Amazon and it's something that you need too, you will find the link to my Amazon store down in my description box. And now,
it's time to craft.
I'm going to use those mesh bags, and that was the item I chose to add into my required items. And then I've got some fabric from Walmart and a scarf from the Dollar Tree and a lot of fabric scraps that I have from my old quilting stash. And some of them are just really cute, like fall type colors, more on the boho side. So I'm going to go with that. And I'm going to cut them into strips, and then I'm going to use some of my jute twine, the bigger jute twine that I get at Walmart, because they have a great deal there. First at the end, I'm going to create a loop with a knot on each side so that I have a place to hang this as a garland when it's all done. So once that knot is created, I'm going to take each strip and just kind of go in a pattern that I have decided on. And I'm going to add each one as a lark's knot and then pull it real tight together to create that garland look. And I'll show you a couple of them done close up and then I'll speed up. So I'm going to put the jute right over the top, and then I'm going to take the bottom and pull it through. I've also folded it in half to start with, just I forgot to mention that. Pull it through and then pull it really tight, move it over to the closest end that where it's starting and pull it down. I'm just going to keep repeating that, go through all the different fabrics and alternate until I have an entire garland. Honestly, there's not a lot to show once I show you how to add the pieces, because you just do it over and over, put on a good TV show, video, something, and just go ahead and do it. It's kind of mindless once you get the hang of it. After I got all of the pieces on, I made another loop at the other end with knots on either side, and now I'm just trimming some of those linen bag pieces because they stretched really long, and I want to try to make these all pretty close in size. I absolutely love how this turned out. It's so boho fall. Let me know what you guys think too. I just want to give another shout out to my friend Rebecca from Home with Rebecca Jane, because she has such a great channel. She has a website and she sells some amazing things. Please check her out. I'll link everything in the description box. And this is the entire group of women involved in this challenge. Hope you'll go watch all the videos, and I'll link as much as I can down below. And if you've come over from any of the other channels, I'm so happy you're here. Welcome. And thank you very much for watching my video. For this DIY, I'm going to use this little wreath form, and then I'm going to take some of those fabric scraps, including the little linen bag. First, I'm going to cut off tags. I'm going to make a little hanger on the back using some jute cord, and I'm just going to wrap them all the way around. I'm going to use some of this burlap from the Dollar Tree, and I'm just going to cut some little strips, and then I'm going to fray the edges by removing a little bit of the pieces all the way around. And I'm going to use these little laser cut leaves that I got at Hobby Lobby on 40% off clearance, and I'm going to hot glue them all the way around the wreath just to give it that combination of color of the teal and the orange. I love that together, and I just feel like this kind of gives it a little bit of that boho vibe at the same time as fall. I have these super cute little straw hats made out of burlap, and I'm going to cut off one side, and then I'm going to hot glue three of them to the top of the wreath, and I just think it adds such a cute little touch. Even though it's not a scarecrow, it makes me think of a scarecrow. I have these really pretty picks from Hobby Lobby. They were $5.99, but with 40% off. It's a little expensive, but they're really nice. I'm just going to cut apart some of the pieces, and I'm going to use the leaves to create a little kind of a pattern. So one on each side, and then I'm going to put some of the little berries, and I've got this little red truck from the Dollar Tree. I'm going to paint it in the agave color, and I'm going to just take off the little wire hanger. I'm going to darken in the tires with a black marker, and then I'm going to remove that little yellow flower with the leaf on it, and I'm going to go ahead and hot glue that right to the kind of bottom right of my wreath. I have these two little orange, I don't know if they're like berries, but I cut off the ends and now they look like pumpkins. So I put one in the back of the truck, one was already there, and then I cut one in half and just kind of put a face down. So it looks like it's got three pumpkins in the back, and I added some more of those little berries just to fill in. I added a little raffia bow with a button in the middle, and that's it. And this turned out so cute. I absolutely love this, and I hope that you guys like it too. I hope my channel is a fun place where you can come and be inspired to create something. I do all different decor styles. There's something here for everyone. If you like what you see, be sure to hit the like button. That really helps my channel grow, and I appreciate it. For this DIY, I'm going to use that little blessed mug. This is a cord, like kind of cover from IKEA. I cut a little piece off. And then the terracotta pot, those two were required. I will also end up using my agave chalk paint, and I'm going to paint the bottom first, and then I'm going to get that dry with my heat tool from Amazon. And then I'm going to paint the whole terracotta pot in the agave. And I'm going to go on the inside just a little bit because I'm going to have rocks in there, so I don't need to go all the way down for that. Once I finish painting with the agave, I'm going to go in with my Waverly White Wax to kind of whitewash it and give it a little bit of, it's not really a distressed, I guess we'll just go with whitewash look. I wanted it to have kind of like a boho fall theme, and I felt like this kind of gave that to me a little bit. Just made it a little more interesting. Now I'm just trying to figure out, how do I want to get this cord cover to stick? And I really want my little mug to kind of be floating, kind of popping out of it. So I'm going to use some E6000 and some hot glue to get that little cord cover thing to stick inside of the pot. But I'm also going to put rocks in there to help secure it as well. But that definitely gets it to stay so I can work with it while I'm doing all of this. And I'm going to hold that until the hot glue dries so that way it's nice and secure. I'm going to take those rocks from the Dollar Tree and I'm going to put them in. Now I do take them out a few times so that I can paint some things, and it's just easier to work without them in there, but I needed to get it in there just so I could see how this was going to look. And I'm taking a little piece of scrap wood and use my miter shears from Amazon, and I'm going to cut it down so that it will fit on the bottom of that little baby mug. And then I'm also going to attach that with E6000 and hot glue to the bottom of the mug. I'm going to paint it with the agave. In case you see it, at least it'll match with the rest of it. And now I'm just attaching it to the bottom of the mug. Once the hot glue dries, then I'm going to cut another little piece of wood to actually sit inside the opening of that cord cover, because I need something to attach the wood that's on the bottom of the little mug to that cord cover. So I get it cut out with my miter shears, I paint it with the agave, and then I'm also going to glue that in, and then I can glue the two pieces of wood together and I'll have a much better seal because of that. There's more surface now. Now I'm taking more of that linen little bag from the Dollar Tree. That is an item that is now required. And I'm going to cut some strips, and I'm going to use that. This isn't a cactus, but I wanted it to kind of have a little bit of that look of a, you know, textured stem, I guess. But first I'm going to just lightly paint my agave over that cord cover. And also I'm going to take the succulent that I was sent, and I'm going to put that in there. I'm going to cut the little foam down so I can add another succulent in there. And then there's something for it to attach to, and it just sits in there perfectly. And now I'm just adding with some hot glue that mesh stuff that I, you know, cut into strips and I'm wrapping around. And I just think it adds kind of a neat texture to the whole thing. Then I'm going to put all my rocks back inside, and I still feel like it needs something, so I added a little skewer stick to help secure the mug. You can't see it right now, but it's in there. And then I'm going to take a bunch of ribbon and burlap, and I'm going to make a messy bow. I'm going to use some twine to tie around the center, and then I'm going to hot glue it to my skewer stick. And this just, to me, gives it that final touch, and I really like how it turned out. I hope you guys like it too. Are you on social media? Come follow me. I'm on Instagram, Pinterest, and Facebook. Same name, Living My Best Life with Lisa Marie. I post all kinds of stuff on there, behind the scenes, and just what's going on in my day-to-day life. Hope to see you there. Do you love mega videos? Check out the link in my description box for a playlist of just that. For this DIY, I'm going to use an empty spice container, which was actually from the Dollar Tree. And then I've got these cute little picks from the Dollar Tree. One is called Bittersweet and one is Cattails. And they're so cute. They really did a good job this year with these. And then I've got a few more strips of my fabric and scarf left over, and then some of my little linen bag. And then I've got these cute straws that were sent to me. So what I'm gonna do now is figure out how long I need to cut my straws so that I can hot glue them all the way around center flat part. So I'm gonna figure that out and then I'm gonna cut them all up. I'm going to hot glue them directly all the way around the spice jar. Then I'm going to take my jute rope from Walmart and I'm going to hot glue that all the way around the bottom little ledge and then the top ledge. Just going to wrap it all around until it's all covered. And I just love the way that looks. It kind of gives it that boho vibe. And then with the colors I'm going to be using, I'm going to be bringing in the fall part. Next, I'm going to take the tags off of my little floral picks and I'm going to cut off the bottom of each stem. And I'm actually not going to cut the pieces apart. I'm going to stick them right in because it just looks so cute together. This was such an easy DIY, you guys. I mean, it's almost like a trash to treasure in a way. I'm going to make a kind of messy bow out of my scarf, my mesh bag, and some ribbon that I got from the Dollar Tree. I'm going to take some jute, I'm going to wrap it around a few times, and I'm going to hot glue this right to the front of my jar. So cute, so easy, and I absolutely love it. I hope you guys like it too. And now for one last look at all four of my mystery box DIYs. It's turned into quite a cute little vignette. It's definitely got that boho fall vibe. I'm really excited with how it looks. I've already put it up in my house. I love these colors. They are definitely my favorite colors for fall. And I hope you guys like them as much as I do. I will have all the links for everyone participating in this mystery box challenge down in my description box, as well as home with Rebecca Jane's channel. Definitely go visit them. You will love everything that they're making. It's going to be so fun.
Thank you so much for watching my video. It really means a lot that you take the time out of your day to watch my videos. And be sure to come back so I can see you in the next one. And remember, you are a blessing to me.
Here are a couple videos I think you might like next. Check them out.